Another highly requested molecule for us to break down is known as hydroxychloroquine, which has a molecular structure that looks like this, and it's very similar to another molecule known as chloroquine, which has the exact same molecular structure depicted here in black. However, it's missing this alcohol group circled in red, or hydroxyl group, and that's where hydroxychloroquine gets its name. And the addition of this group to chloroquine, you can think of like a second version, as this has been shown to be more easily absorbable for patients and have less side effects. Now, hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine are used to prevent or treat malaria, as well as treat rheumatoid arthritis or lupus. And the molecules themselves are relatively basic when we look at the pH scale. So those could be either highly acidic or highly alkaline. And they're highly targeted to a specific organelle within our cells known as the lysosome. And the lysosome is highly acidic, and it's used to break down old materials within our cells, such as proteins that are no longer needed, break them down to their individual amino acids, and then allow the cell to use those amino acids for other processes. So when the lysosome comes in contact with hydroxychloroquine, it's actually going to raise the pH, so it won't be as acidic. Therefore, the process of recycling materials will be affected, as well as another process known as autophagy. So in parasites, these two processes being affected inhibits growth and replication. Also, if we look at lupus and arthritis, by having the lysosome affected, this has been shown to decrease toll-like receptor signaling and cytokine production, which is known to cause inflammation. So by having these processes diminished, therefore we see reduced inflammation. However, the exact mechanism of this is still unknown. So make sure to leave a comment below if you want to see additional molecules broken down, and stay connected with my channel and Dane Garvin.